Module compiler is type of a translator which converts human oriented programming language, that is called higher level language, into the machine oriented or a computer oriented machine language, that is known as a machine level language. Means in simple word we can say compiler converts higher level language into the machine understandable language, that is nothing but we can say the binary language, that is in form of 0 and 1. Machine only can understand that binary language, that is in form of 0 and 1. So the structure is like this. The input is programming language, that we can say the source code. Then compiler process that source code which is written in a higher level language and then convert that code into the machine understandable language, that is known as a target code. So how that is possible? So this complete process means conversion from the higher level language to the machine language, it performs in a number of components. So we can say the phases of compiler, there are the number of phases for the compiler which is used to, that phases are required to convert a machine level language, that higher level language into the machine level language. So mainly the compiler must perform a two major tasks. First, that is known as analysis one, and second is a synthesis. Analysis means it analyzes the source program, and synthesis of a machine level program. So the structure of compiler is like this. So that these all are the components of the compiler. First component of the compiler is lexical analyzer. The input of lexical analyzer is character stream, that is nothing but we can say the source code. It converts that character stream, it distinguished that set of statements and or the character stream into the token stream. Then that token stream become an input of a syntax analyzer and it generates the syntax tree. That syntax tree is again part as an input of semantic analyzer and again it generates the semantic tree. Basically the semantic analyzer is required to check the type checking type of operations, and then that syntax tree has become an input of intermediate code generator, that is what the intermediate representation of the source code. Then it generates the machine independent code optimizer. Again in that intermediate representation of the source code, but the code should be in a optimum format. Then after a code generator, that is what the target machine code, and then after machine dependent code optimizer. During this all the phases, this all phases are connected with the two advanced data structure, that is what the symbol, table and error handler. These two advanced data structures are connected with the each and every phases of compiler, and symbol table manage all the list of symbols available into the source code, and error handler handles the error which are generated in a different phases of compiler. Let's see in a detail what happened. That first phase, that is lexical analysis phase, is also known as a scanner. The scanner begins the analysis of a source program by reading the input character by character and grouping that characters into individual words, that is called token. Now second phase is syntax analysis, that is known as a parser. It gives a formal syntax specification. The parse reads the tokens which is generated by the lexical analysis and groups them into units as specified by production of the CFG being used. As the syntactic structure is recognized, the parser either calls the corresponding semantic routines directly or build a syntax tree. That we all are familiar with the context tree grammar, that is what it generates the parse with. And after that, a semantic routine, we have already seen in a semantic routine as well, the output of semantic analysis is what? The parse tree. So it just check for the type checking and the meaning of the statement, whether everything is correct or not, and then it generates the very fast way. If any type conversion is required, it perform that type of type conversions for any of the variable, then that is done in a semantic analysis. Then optimizer basically just try to optimize the code, and it reduces the set of lines in the program. It reduces the complexity of the code. The complete process is very complex and slow, but output of that that phase is what the code set of lines in the code, it's quite less. In code generation, it generates the code which is which machine can understand. That is what the interpretive code generation. Here you can see the diagram. For example with diagram, if we have a syntax or a statement like position is equal to initial plus rate into 60, then